Good morning and welcome to Erasmus TV. My name is Tessa Hofland. I'm an editor at Erasmus Magazine. Today we'll be talking about the Corona crisis and what it means for international and exchange students. Next to me is Rose Korver from the International Office. How are you? Is it rush hour for you?
A little bit, yes. The situation changes so quickly that we have to keep on top of it.
And back by popular demand, our president of the executive board, Hans Smits. Yes.
Good morning.
Good morning. Do you have any updates in the university policy?
Well, I think it's good to underline that for our students abroad, we have them all on the list, and we will invite them to come home. And we will then facilitate that, and we will compensate the extra cost if the insurance does not pay. So that's first, and if they do not want to come to the Netherlands back, then they should confirm it writing. So we take care of them, absolutely. So I'm curious how many of them will go back. That's the first thing, change in the policy. Secondly, of course, we have a lot of international students here in the Netherlands. We are going to have a long list of them. And we will decide, I think, tomorrow what we will do for their welfare, their well-being, etc., etc.
Is it easy to keep track of all these Dutch students abroad?
We have a list of all Dutch students currently studying abroad. We have contact with them through email. They received the invitation to come back to the Netherlands yesterday. We keep track on them.
And would you urge them to give you a response?
Well, you cannot demand it from students to give you a response. Their private movings are private, but we hope to keep track of who's coming back.
And universities abroad are already calling students back. For example, in the United States, our reporter Feba visited Hatta. It's the building here on campus where a lot of international students live.
How are you?
I'm great, yeah. I'm going back to the United States tomorrow, Thursday morning, yeah.
But I heard that all the flights from Europe are banned?
Yes, but not for U.S. citizens. I'm an exchange student here, so my university called me back, everything's canceled.
I was going to my home country, like, in 20th, but I just found out that the airplane is, like, canceled and all shit, and I'm an exchange student and all most of our students are going back.
Okay. Did you buy a lot of things, a lot of food at the supermarket?
No, but we're well equipped. Well, this is mostly like snacks, cereals, and here we have more rice, pasta. Here we have milk, yogurt, salad, eggs. More for salad and...
So, as we saw in the video, a lot of students are considering or already planning to go home. Rose, what kind of questions are you getting from students? How are they feeling?
Well, the last 2 weeks we received a lot of questions about should I go back? Unfortunately, we do not have a proper answer to that yet. We hope to have it in a few days. And we also received a lot of questions about... the rental contract they have in Hatta building, for example. We are very happy to say that last Monday we decided together with SSH that exchange students can terminate their contract earlier than August 2020. We're very happy with that.
Yeah, because it's only for students living here on Hatta or on campus.
Yeah.
That's correct. So they don't have any financial disadvantage of going back earlier than planned. That's correct. Yeah. Yes.
And for the students who want to stay here, what kind of advice would you give them? Because I can imagine that they're feeling lonely being so far away from home. Yeah. And they would love to gather and have dinner all together. But what would you advise them?
Well, luckily we haven't had any emails or messages about loneliness yet. We hope that students find each other online, that they find the student associations online. Yesterday, I had contact with the Erasmus Student Network, also known as ESN. And they invite especially international students who feel lonely to contact them as well. Well, it's the online way, but still, it is a way to contact each other. Yeah.
And to close, Hans, are you worried for the next academic year? Because, well, this is the time that students would have to sign up.
Yeah.
And international students are quite a large part of the student population here.
Yeah, definitely. So worried, but also it's a challenge to take care of that. So I think this week there will be a decision about the binding study advice. There will be a decision made about the 15th of April, because for that normally you have to subscribe the first stage, I would say. So I think we will take care of that, and we will be flexible as possible so that students don't have big disadvantages of this whole virus crisis.
That was it for today. Thank you very much for watching. If you have any questions, and I can imagine that you have quite some questions, you can send them to us and we will make sure that you get an answer on one of our channels. Thank you very much. Hopefully we'll see you tomorrow.